नमः शिवाय। ओम नमः शिवाय।
हरि ओम। दक्षाध्वरहरः। दक्ष वॉज द प्रजापति, अध्वर मीन्स द यज्ञ, एंड हरः मीन्स वन हु डिस्ट्रॉयड। सो लॉर्ड शिवा हैड डिस्ट्रॉयड द यज्ञ ऑफ दक्ष प्रजापति, हेंस ही इज कॉल्ड दक्षाध्वरहरः। नाउ व्हाई डिड ही डिस्ट्रॉय दैट यज्ञ ऑफ दक्ष प्रजापति? दक्ष मीन्स वन हु इज वेरी स्किलफुल, एंड दक्ष वॉज वेरी ईगोइस्टिक एंड एरोगेंट, एंड ही डिड नॉट इन्वाइट लॉर्ड शिवा फॉर अ यज्ञ दैट ही वॉज डूइंग। दैट यज्ञ वॉज कॉल्ड बृहस्पति सवन। वाई डिड ही नॉट इन्वाइट द लॉर्ड? देर आर थ्री रीजन्स, वी विल सी वेरी सून। बट भगवान डिस्ट्रॉयड हिज यज्ञ टू हम्बल हिज प्राइड, टू डिस्ट्रॉय हिज ईगो, and for his own well-being. Because the more ego we have, the more arrogant we are, the more suffering we experience in life. So it was an act of compassion to bring Daksha back to his senses and to humble his pride, to make him surrender. Bhagwan destroyed his yajna. Now why did Daksha not invite Lord Shiva? So there are three different reasons given for it. First reason is, it is said that once Maharshi Durvasa went to a place called Jambunada and he meditated on a Maya Bija, a mantra to propitiate Mother Jagadambika, who was the deity of that place, and she is the mother of the whole world also. So with intense tapas, he propitiated her, and in turn she blessed him with a garland that she was wearing, and that garland was oozing nectar. It had great fragrance, it was oozing nectar, and it was a divine garland. Durvasa Muni wore it and he went to the palace of Daksha. Daksha was very fascinated with this garland. So Durvasa Muni gave the garland to him, saying it is a divine garland and how he had got it. Now Daksha Prajapati took this garland to his bedroom and he hung it there and he copulated with his wife. In this way, he insulted the garland which was divine and he polluted it. Then Lord Shiva and Sati, Sati is the daughter of Daksha Prajapati, when they both came to know of this, they are the mother and the father of the whole universe, they came and they scolded Daksha. Now Daksha held this bitterness in his heart and he did not like Lord Shiva. This was the first reason he did not invite Lord Shiva to the yajna that he was performing, Brihaspati Savana. This story is mentioned in the Devi Bhagavatam in the 7th skanda. The second reason why Daksha did not invite Lord Shiva is, he considered Lord Shiva as polluted. Lord Shiva lives in the cremation ground, wears the garland of skulls, has ashes all over him, there are ghosts and goblins around him, and also in his hand is the skull, the fifth head of Brahmaji, which always remains in his hand. One of his earlier names also spoke about it. So Daksha considered Lord Shiva as polluted, not very royal. He didn't think of Lord Shiva as royal. So he did not invite Lord Shiva. And the third reason is the most famous one, where some Prajapatis were doing a yajna and they had invited all the devatas, great rishis, sadhu, sannyasis, Brahmaji, Vishnu Bhagwan, all were there. And even Lord Shiva was there. And when he entered, everybody welcomed him, praised him. He took his seat And as per his directions, everybody took up their places also. But when Daksha entered, everyone got up to praise Daksha. Lord Shiva did not get up. This angered Daksha that Lord Shiva is just his son-in-law and he did not even get up. So in front of everyone, he criticized Lord Shiva, called him polluted, called him unholy, called him ignorant, outcasted him from all the four Varnas and sent him out from that yajna. Lord Shiva is Param Vairagi. He never took it personally and he went. So these are three reasons why Daksha did not invite Lord Shiva. But as we said, Lord Shiva is Param Vairagi. He did not bother that I was not invited to the yajna Brihaspati Savana by Daksha. He was quiet. But Sati came to know that all are invited and they have not got an invitation. And she was very eager to go. And Bhagwan said, we are not invited. Let us not go there. But Sati insisted. So Bhagwan didn't stop her, but he didn't join her also. So she went. And when she went, she saw that there was no seat kept for the Lord. And they were not even ready to give her the offerings meant for the Lord. And the father did not even look at Sati. He insulted her. So Sati felt very, very offended. She can't go back to Lord Shiva now and her own father also is not acknowledging her presence. So she created Yog Agni and immolated herself. This angered Lord Shiva. That Daksha took it personally and it should have been between him and Lord Shiva, if at all. But he treated Sati very badly. And in that process, Sati immolated herself. So Bhagwan was very angry and with his jata, he created Veerabhadra and Bhadrakali. And along with many other ganas, they both went and destroyed the sacrifice of Daksha and beheaded Daksha also. And they were still very angry and they were creating havoc in the world. So everybody prayed to the Lord that please control them and quieten them and tell them to come back to you. So finally Bhagwan quietened them and asked them to return. And upon the prayers of the Devatas, the Lord restored Daksha's life also, placed the head of a goat, and Daksha's pride was humbled. Now, the story is not about ego. It is not that Lord Shiva felt offended that he was not called and hence he destroyed the yajna of Daksha. The story is about having the arrogance not to involve the Lord, thinking I am skilled, I can do everything on my own. It is about thinking that my actions can give me results. I don't need Lord at all in this picture. Thirdly, when one is acting out of ego, one loses objectivity. And as a result, Sati lost her life. And fourthly, any Vedic ritual, when we do, the Lord is the karma phala data. A yajna which is done without invoking the Lord is called Nirishvara yajna. And that yajna can only boost the ego, which will finally land the jiva into more and more suffering. So out of compassion, Bhagwan humbled the pride of Daksha and made him realize his flaw. This story is also symbolic and there are many lessons to learn for us that we may think we are very skilled, we can do everything by ourselves, but we should remember that all these skills come to us by the grace of the Lord. The environment in which we perform our actions are provided to us by the Lord. The laws that govern this whole world, because of which our actions give us certain results, are also created by the Lord. We are alive because of the presence of the Lord in us. So everything that happens, happens only by the grace of the Lord. So we should not become arrogant with our skills, thinking that I am very skilled, and in that process, we forget the Lord. Hence, may we remember this always, that our skills, our talents, our capabilities, our achievements, all these are only by the grace of the Lord. May we remember the Lord always, act in the spirit of dedication to the Lord, and live with humility, with gratitude.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.